Welcome to the NBA Math Hoops tutorial video explaining the draft.
The draft is very important and can be the determining factor of how your season will go.
As co-coaches, each team will draft 5 players from the NBA or WNBA to complete their team. Each team will play with these players until lesson 9, the trade deadline, when they have to trade at least 1 player to finish the season.
When you receive your NBA Math Hoops materials, you'll get packs of player cards that include 64 NBA and WNBA players. To start the draft, you should lay all of the player cards on a table by color and position, with the data faced up, in order to encourage statistical analysis through the selection process.
There are 5 different types of player cards, and they are color-coded as within the 5 positions that are in the NBA. The guards are yellow and red, the forwards are blue and purple, and the centers are usually green, but sometimes purple.
Before they actually draft, you can assign the draft order in any creative way that you'd like. Attendance, behavior, or just random assignment are some of the best practices that educators have used.
After you have figured out the order of the draft, you are ready to execute the draft. If you've ever played fantasy sports, you know that there is a unique way of drafting called the snake draft.
The snake draft refers to the strategy when the order of the draft reverses each round. For example, 1 through 10, then 10 through 1, and so on for 5 rounds. Each round, students will pick 1 player card of their choice until they have selected all 5 player cards, 1 of each color, to complete their team.
On the back of the player cards, you will see 3 different stats and percentages. In the top left corner, you'll see the 2-point percentage, which is represented in the orange area of the circle graph. In the middle of the card, you'll see a 3-point percentage, which is represented in the black lines on the circle graph.
On the right side of the card, you will see a free throw percentage and a grid that represents the free throw percentage of that player.
It's also cool to know that all of these stats are represented in decimal format. That's how the NBA and WNBA present statistics, even though they are called percentages. Students will want to draft the players with the best statistics to help them have a great season.